there's a reason that Tom and I met, and, you know, we're pretty much the same guy in two different bodies. I feel like we're brothers, and same thing with Travis. When Travis came along, it was the perfect time, and he added something to the band that we never had here before, and he added a dynamic of friendship that I know for a fact that our band would never have gotten to where it is without the three of us finding each other.
Blink-182 to us has always just been three really close friends having a lot of fun.
Being in Blink-182 has obviously taught me a lot of stuff, you know, about being in a band and just having a good time. It's obviously opened up doors for me to play live shows and just get a chance to play drums and have everyone see my band.
Tom and I have been through everything together. We used to sleep in the van together. We used to sleep on people's floor together. We've been there for each other since day one, and we've gone through everything.
He's full of energy. He's like a little kid. He's just super funny and always has a good time.
He's my best friend, and I'm sure he'll always be my best friend. You know, he's the first person that I think when I find out when something happens, he's the first person that I want to call and tell him about it.
I just have a good time with him. We write well together and walk well together and talk well together. And he's a great friend and a great person to be in a band with.
We would just laugh so hard. We'd make up the stupidest things. And when I'm old, I'll look back to those times and just remember how hard we all laughed.
Mark's and my relationship has grown a lot. He was a nut. And the very first thing he did was climb to a light pole and jumped off it. And hurt his ankles and was on crutches for 3 weeks. And I was like, what is this guy doing? It was really, really weird. We were so alike. We just became best friends and have been that way ever since.
From the day I met him, I remember he was a super nice guy. Really good friend, though, willing to do anything for anybody, and just a good-looking dude.
We just get closer and closer, and we have this really cool communication between us that we can tell each other anything and we can confide in each other, but then we also feel like we can make fun of everybody and everyone's different from us, not like we're different from them, and it's pretty cool. It's one of those guys, like every day you have to talk to somebody, and like every day I have to talk to Mark. If I don't, it's just not the same day.
Travis is just one of my closest friends. Mark and I are both so super stoked and grateful that he's in a band with us.
We were on tour with a band that Travis used to play in, and we needed a drummer because our old drummer Scott had to leave for the day. That night he played the set with us, and after the show, Tom and I sat down together and said, this is our drummer. This is the real drummer from Blink-182. And there was never any second thought or any second choice at all. Travis was our friend.
And so we were trying to like figure him out for the longest time, and we did. He's such a great guy, and he's got such a rad personality, and he's so into friendship and so into like being there for his friends and stuff, and it's just been amazing. It made our band so tight to have another guy that we can really share a friendship that was really cool and really strong.
He's always trying to make himself a better musician, a better songwriter, better performer. He practices more than anybody that I've ever met.
Like, you come up with music and, you know, you're like, how many different ways can you make a punk rock song? But there's like 101 ways with Travis.
I mean, aside from being just a really cool guy and one of my best friends, he's probably the best musician that I've ever met. Tom and Travis are my brothers, and I'd do anything for those guys. When all this is said and done, we'll all be together looking back and going, fuck, we made it. You know, this is amazing. How did we do it? I think back even now, even when I walk in on stage and I look out and I see all the people, I get so blown away, and I just think, wow, we made it.
And so many other bands just fight and they don't get along and they hate each other, but when things come down the road that are hard and gnarly, you know, it's just us three, I feel like we can, it doesn't matter, like we don't care, we can do anything.
I think about times when we were traveling in the van and we'd make up stupid songs or we'd make up jokes, and we were so poor back then, we couldn't even barely afford gas to get to the next venue, but we were having so much fun just playing music and being in a band and watching our dreams come true.
I think Mark and Tom will be my friends forever. Fucking friends forever and ever and ever.
We've been through this crazy trip, and we've seen the world, and we've gotten to do all the things that we ever dreamed about, and we've gotten to do it on our own terms.
And I think it's been an amazing trip here, but I think we're going to be one of those bands that's around forever and always makes records, even if nobody's buying them and using them for toilet paper. But we'll still make them because we'll be the best fucking toilet paper anybody's ever used.
I'm sick of always hearing all those sad songs on the radio. All day, it is there to remind an oversensitive guy that he's lost and alone, yeah. Restaurant, our favorite movie, our favorite show. We would stay up all through the night. We would laugh and get high and never answer the phone.
This is what Mark does. Hi, I'm Mark. Hi. And then this is Travis.
I'm Travis.
This is me. Hey, what's up?
Said this was right.
Our room.
It stops the door from opening.
I'm excited to play because tonight it's gonna be completely light outside and we're gonna walk out.
The smoke.
Look, Mark just kissing everybody's ass.
Oh, like you're not.
We're calling people that left us notes of sombrero. Hi, can I have Mr. Kaznowski, please? Who is this? I can't understand what you said. What was that? Hi. I can't hear what you're saying. I'm sorry.
If these kids only know, he calls my house every morning at 7.
Oh, what's up, dude?
That's like almost really weird and bad.
This is your dick, Cheetah.
I was gonna be a model for Calvin Klein.
No, you weren't.
You're right, I wasn't.
A bunch of my friends want to know why you never talk about soccer or chicken fighting.
We'll come back and maybe we'll get into some of Corona's better sports.
I'm kicking. Fiercely.